Right, we're back in the saddle again now. Just a little Bimble's Devil's Bridge at Kirby Lonsdale. In between the showers. But it's a windy day, so the wind noise is going to be even worse than normal. As I've mentioned before, although I think the Interceptor 650 is a cracking bike out of the box, the suspension is a little bit, as it's settled down, it's not bad, it's just, yeah, I suppose you could tweak it a little bit. And the front end, I've noticed that they going over some of the the roads around here, they're not great, I tell you. And you just tend to notice to be a little bit, not pogery, more clattery. I mean, clattery is not a word, but... So, have a look online, well, I look on the Facebook forums or whatever. And a chap had a solution. Basically, it's a spacer that you put in under the top nut, and it just takes out a bit of the sag from the spring. I've got to say, I mean, I've just fitted it this morning, and I can notice the difference. And it's a really, really, really cheap fix. There's a vlogger, whatever they call it, on YouTube called Dorman Diaries. D-O-R-M-A-N Diaries. And he does a bit of a feature about them. So, if you want any technical information or whatever, just go on there. Definitely tightened it up. Only a bit, only marginally. But if, like me, you're happy enough to a degree with it as it is, saves spending 250, 300 quid on a full front suspension upgrade. I mean, I dare say the full front suspension upgrade would make a hell of a difference, but it don't need it. Would I get it? Would I get one? Maybe. That might be something for the future, I guess, because I'm not bothered about it. I'm not going to sell this bike. I'm in love with it too much. One thing I am slightly disappointed with, that's probably a bit more than slightly. I keep my bikes as immaculate as I possibly can. I always have done. So I'm really disappointed to see so much. I don't know. The rear shock inside behind the spring has just gone black and cruddy, and it won't come off. So I've bitten the bullet and ordered a set pair of YSS G-top shock absorbers for the rear. They're due to come tomorrow. As I've said before, I'm not that bothered about the performance of the shock, but I don't like to have a bike that looks shitty. Just me. Some of the other mods I fancy doing. I fancy the Hitchcocks, who do a lot of Royal Enfield spares, who decat downpipes for this bike in stainless. Quite tempted with them. Get a set of adjustable handlebar levers, just because of a little bit of a stretch. I've only got tiny hands, not girly hands. They're nothing major. And it's over time. I haven't got everything today. Twat. Thank you. I still stand by what I say though, that out of the box it's a damn fine bike. And really all I'm thinking of doing is just tweaking it. Just tweaks. And these spacers have taken that little bit of crashiness out of the front springs. They weren't that bad. And I bought these spacers, I haven't been given them. Like I say, want the details on them, go on to Dorman Diaries. I think he helped with the development of them as well. Company called Motone Customs do a bar riser conversion. It lifts it up by an inch and pulls them back by an inch. If they were cheaper I might try a set of them, but nah, they're too dear. Like I say, it's all tweaks. There we are, Devil's Bridge. Only one bike here today. Right, signing off. See you in a bit. You're welcome. Great thing in it about the biking world, you pull up like I pulled up there, there was just the one other bike and you start talking to you. Couldn't do that in the car, would you? You wouldn't just pull up somewhere and then somebody else was sitting on a wall and just start having a chat. Ah, maybe you would, but it's not as common. Yes, definitely made a difference, these spaces have. Got my glasses. Glasses are annoying me today. Safely say that those 20 spaces have definitely made a difference. Right, signing off.